Welcome to Country Stitchers. We were talking about our Easter piece, and this is the overdyed floss that I'm going to do the letters in. And I got that out just because you were going to start working on yours. And I, going through the project bags, I cleaned out my project bags and did the fabric. That's the upcoming part, is to get all the fabric put back. But in going through the project bags, it was like, oh my gosh, I forgot I had that for spring. And that was this one. Do you remember?
Oh,
Mary
yes.
Had a Little Lamb.
Yeah.
This was in...
Yeah, what was that?
A magazine. Well, it was actually my keepsake calendar, and that was the month of September.
Oh, yeah.
And they had Mary Had a Little Lamb. And I hadn't gotten very far by the time I...
Who's the designer?
Goodness, I'd have to turn it around and look. Was it Barbara Anna, I believe, is the designer on that. Yeah, Barbara Anna. So, the fabric was just gorgeous. I love it. It's a white chocolate.
Oh, we like white chocolate. Yeah, it's
32.
Gorgeous.
32. I love the feel of it.
Yeah, it's pretty.
So I'm anxious to do this. I had this in my stash, I believe. You know, was that white chocolate or platinum? It's one of the two. I'll have to check my
I don't know. They did
my
this
tag.
On
I have it
wool,
written
so I'm not
now.
Sure, but that's really pretty.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. No, I didn't do it on the lamb's wool. I do remember. I think I changed that out. And it's DMCs, which make it really nice and easy to do.
Yeah.
And then I have a. Another piece on my, you might remember the Shepherd's Bush fold. A friend of ours, Sandy, She did this, and when we were away, I didn't get a chance to share this with you yet. I still have, I'm working on the main piece for the shaker top. I still have to do this. But they did it differently, and she gave me a picture of it. There's a different saying on theirs, and... The saying, this just says a full heart on this one. And this saying was done by Sally, I believe, and she stitched it this way. A stitcher's box is such a must to hold our tools we do in trust.
Oh, cute.
And so Sally is at Salty Yarn. She was the previous owner. Sarah now runs the business, but Sally's there, and you'll see her anytime you're in.
That's really pretty.
I just got my letter from them. Did you get yours about the retreat?
Mm-mm.
I got my Jamboree letter yesterday, so maybe yours will be in the
mail
today.
Yeah.
So anyway, Sandy was kind enough to give me the way that Sally graphed this, and I really like it, so
that's how
I'm going to do this
one.
So I have another piece that I pulled out to work on, another small. I think I have 3 of the 5 smalls, and then they had 2 additional ones. I'm not sure I'm going to put them all in my... shaker boxes. Some of the pieces are quite big, the pillows. And then this is the needle roll I'm going to pull out and keep handy to work on.
That's pretty.
It's fun to have something like this, but I'm also doing that other kit that that has all the specialty stitches that I showed last week.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I want to keep going between the two of them, because otherwise it'll be it'll be a challenge as to what we're going to do. And last is, you might remember this, I have the pin cushion on the top to do, and the fob, and then half the band. So basically about halfway through.
Oh my gosh. When we were away, I'm so sleepy. I can't even think.
She brought my Rhapsody in Blue. Yes.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. That was gorgeous.
And I was going to share that with you,
that was so pretty.
But remember, all my photos disappeared.
Oh yeah.
I had taken pictures of her finish on it, and that is in my finish. Yeah. That is the only discouraging part of going through the section of the craft room I did last time, was because my basket full of stuff that needs finished is huge. So we need to focus on that, because it's not a lot of, I wouldn't say that there's too much that I can't do it, but you don't see it, you don't think about it. It's
yeah,
not in
that's
front of
true.
You.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. All right, before we move on, should we, because
yes,
our
we
bell
should.
Went off?
Subscribe to Tribute.
Yes.
And our Dimensions giveaway.
Yes. Let's start with the Dimensions giveaway. So, Kimberly Mears, you will be receiving Ivan.
Yes.
The bird dog.
And Kimberly's a fairly new subscriber.
Oh, well, welcome. And
yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you to all of our subscribers.
And may I say that letting people know how to adjust their settings...
Oh, yeah.
Had a big impact for me, because there were so many people that I would come up against and not see them and not be able to do anything, but yet I knew that they'd been with us for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So, way to go. I'm finding you now.
Yeah.
So, that's really good.
Kimberly, if you can get a hold of me, my email address is in the drop-down box, and then I will get that sent right out to you. And for our subscriber tributes, the first one is Car Kicks Door. And again, these are your YouTube channel names. You will be receiving a pattern from Riveris. Beautiful one. It says Queen on it, and it has a B-skep. It's really, really pretty. And the way they finished it is very pretty. There's also a really nice charm and some lace that comes with this. Thank you again, Riveris, for sending this to us to pass along to our subscribers. Beautiful. So if you could also get a hold of me, and then the next subscriber tribute goes to Robin Harvey, and you'll be getting a Riveris pattern, and it says Daisy on it. Again, finished beautifully in that pillow, and there is a really pretty charm on the back of that as well. Really, really. Very fun, summery patterns.
Two little charms.
Yeah.
Fun.
Very pretty. So thank you again, Riveris, and... Oh my gosh, that's wonderful. Nice summer stitching.
It's fun to share that kind of joy, isn't
it? Yeah, it is fun. And so for our next Dimensions giveaway, if anybody's interested, you'll be receiving this. It's Hank's girlfriend.
Henrietta.
We should name her, yes. Hank and Henrietta. That's cute. I need a Hank. But yes, you will be receiving this, maybe in the comment section, if you could say something about Hank. And,
okay.
And let me see how many people will be like, Hank, who's Hank? You'll just have to watch some previous videos and find out. But, yes, if you mention anything about Hank in, the comment section of the video, then, or in our next video, we will be passing this one along. And thank you again, Dimensions.
Yes. Thank you very much.
All right.
And
okey-dokey.
I have a pattern, and this is by Northern Lights.
Oh, pretty.
By Laura Perrin Designs. Or it's called Northern Lights, I'm sorry. And I'll show you the top part of it there. It's a freebie off of her internet site, I believe it was. This goes back to the early 2000s when I was in the Guild in Illinois. I did the autumn version of this, mm-hmm. and it's on my wall in the craft room here. But this is done with a cold palette. And
is that
it's
flower thread?
Yep, there's flower thread, krynek.
Pretty.
Pearl cotton. And so that's the color palette. And I'm going to send along this piece of Congress cloth with it. It's plenty big enough to do it.
Oh, so this is an adoption piece.
Yes, it is.
Nice.
We are up for adoption.
Nice. So if anyone would like to give this a home.
Yes.
What would you like them to say?
Let's just put in Laura.
Laura?
Laura Perrin Designs. Yeah.
Okay.
L-A-U-R-A.
So if someone is interested in Hank and Laura.
Yes.
That's okay?
Yes.
That's funny. All right.
All righty.
That's a pretty piece.
It is, and it'll be fun done. It's just I have
It's a fun done.
I have quite a few needlepoint and counted thread pieces I'm working on, and this one's been there since then, mm-hmm. and I thought it's time to share it.
Yeah. All right. Wonderful.
Okay.
Perfect. So, Liz, got some finishes?
I do. I do. Funny you should ask. Should we do Gadget Corner?
Fine. Just kidding. Yes.
Okay. The reason I say it is because there's something over my shoulder here, and I had this last video, but forgot to bring it around to the front. And so I didn't talk about it at all. We showed this magnifying sheet that is kind of a... I just want to show it down here first. It magnifies, but it can magnify a page at a time. One of our viewers was saying that they had trouble. I was assuming that they wanted to magnify a section at a time on their pattern. And I have mentioned that what you needed to make it work would be something that would hold it onto your stand, mm-hmm. and hold it away from your piece.
Oh, that works perfectly.
So if you could do that now. So this little gadget is called, it's by Kensington, and it's made to hold papers on your typing stand or your computer at work. But it works perfectly for this, and I knew it was in my craft room somewhere. I found it. And so you can see the difference in the magnification when it's out farther from the page. So you can do that over a large area while you're stitching and be able to see the symbols much, much easier.
That's awesome.
Huh. Yeah. So that's just to give you that nice last piece of information. And where we talked about that magnifier, also thank you to the people who made the comments about Dollar Tree.
Oh, yeah.
They do sell these at Dollar Tree, which means they're only a dollar.
I was going to just ask you, how much is it, Liz?
She's my sidekick. So today's Gadget Corner is needle threaders. And this is kind of got a little story to it. Deb and I went to Hobby Lobby a few weeks ago. And you've seen many different types of needle threaders. This one is often seen with kits with magnets and things that go on your board, little project kits that Low Rand makes these. They have a larger side and a smaller side, and this just slides through the eye of the needle and you can pull your thread back through. It has a little hole you can attach it to a fob or a string or something to keep you from losing it. Mm-hmm. This is the same idea. It's got two sides. This one, you can buy multiple ones together in a packet. Same with the other one, too. And it has a hole in the center so you can attach it to beads or whatever you want to keep with it so you don't lose it. And the only thing I find with these, have you ever done this with a fine thread and had it actually break your thread when you're pulling it through a small needle? I've had it actually, these small metal ones can actually go through the thread. So I was looking at other ones, and I was looking for a smaller way to engage the thread to go through, as opposed to even what you would consider that to be fairly small. But if you have a really tiny beading needle, this won't make it. So I found this in a quilting shop. It's by Ginger, and it's got that tiny little blade that you see there coming up. Now, it's designed so that you slide the eye of your needle into the side. Then you bring your thread over the top. So your needle goes in here, and your thread just comes up over the top, and then you slide the thread right through. And you can't miss your needle because it's engaged in the side of this little device. It's very, very easy to use. But these run upwards of $20.
Wow.
Just like the Ginger scissors with the really pretty inlaid handles and things, those are pricey. And this actually has a scissor that matched, but this was on sale and not the scissor I bought, the one that was on sale for my threader. Later, when we were at Hobby Lobby, I was walking along and I saw this and I couldn't take it out of the package before today because you need the full effect here. First, the price is $3.99. Then all of the things that it tells you it comes with a finger grip, which is this little indentation on the side. It comes with your threader, which is this very small, and I believe this may even be smaller than the Ginger. Then a cover that snaps down, and then you have a hole for your lanyard. And then the very last, that's actually a little blade, and you can cut your thread with it. And then there's a hole for your lanyard. So you get this package deal here for the bargain basement price of $3.99. So I'm going to take it out of here now that you've seen all those different features it comes with.
And it's cute.
And it is. It's very cute. And I think, I hope I didn't want to save that for a minute. Mm-hmm. It really destroyed it. The only difference being that the one by Ginger, your needle gets slipped into that little reservoir or divot on the side, and it's very hard to miss your target with your needle. This one, you actually poke it through. Wow.
It's childproof.
Yeah, they're not going to lose that. Okay, so this little cover slides right down, keeps it from getting harmed. But then you're kind of on your own when you're sliding this through the eye of your needle. So that's the only difference between that one and Ginger. But I thought for $3.99, that's a really nice tool to have in your
kit.
Yeah, that's cute. And that makes it very nice for a plane with that little blade.
Mm-hmm.
While, I mean, that'll go in your coin purse.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody's going to stop you. Nobody's going to stop you. So
cute.
If you're looking for needle threaders, there's also the old standby. You take a little piece of paper, you fold it nice and thin, and you use it when you're trying to go through a tapestry needle like a size 22 or a size 20. That works perfectly if you don't have a threader.
That is nice. That's tiny.
And then you can always run the eye of your needle over the side of your finger with your thread and pull it up through there. So
cute.
You can do it with or without a guide.
Yes.
So that's Gadget nice. Corner today.
Cool.
So you said something about finishes, huh?
Yes.
Deb hasn't seen them. She's probably been peeking at the top of this box.
I do see a box.
Oh. We did not thank everybody at this point. I just realized. We've gone past 8,000 subscribers.
Oh, yeah.
That's
yes. Thank you very much.
Amazing.
Thank you.
That was a surprise, but it was really cute. Was it's our 81st video and 8,100 subscribers.
Yeah, that's cool.
That. And this is the month that we started doing our videos.
Oh, yeah. We're almost at our 2-year anniversary.
Yes, we are.
Yeah. Nice.
So I forgot to show you these. You might see these again in something that we might do for our anniversary. But these little scissors, these were so cute. I got these at the Missouri Quilt Company, Missouri Star Quilt Company. And they reminded me of the little stork. You know, they're these tiny little scissors.
All right. These are the ones that I like to take on the plane with me. The itty bitties. And they're sharp. These little babies, man, I'll tell you what, they are sharp.
Do you remember when we first saw them? Do you remember the lady at Silver Needle, our retreat, who had done that cute little Easter stitching kit? It had all the little bunnies stitched on it in pieces. And she had a light yellow or orange sort of pastel pair of these with this little handle, bracelet, whatever, attached to one of her little bunny fobs.
Oh,
and I remember thinking,
that,
what a cute little scissor.
They are awesome, though. I love to take those with me when I travel.
Yep, they are fun. You remember when I ordered them the first time?
Yes.
I think I got them. Well, we got some different colors that time. I forget.
Yeah.
I had a blue pair at one point. Okay. You might remember my Paula Smith. Plumstreet Sampler. That'll come out. And Paula Stewart, her design, a tire must run between us today.
Oh my God, that's funny. People are going to be like, who's this new design, Paula Smith?
I just invented her. This is the top of the box.
Love it.
And this was Deb's idea to use two fabrics to finish it. I had plenty of linen, but Deb thought it might give it some depth and some texture to add the wool on the side, and so I used that idea, and that's what we came up with.
Love it. It's beautiful.
I got that put together.
Perfect.
This week. And it's a nice size box. I'll show you the side of it, but it's full of other things I'm going to show you right now, so I'm not going to put the lid back on. So
it's a goodie box.
Yeah. So that's goodie.
Very
cool. I was happy with that.
Yeah.
And here, this took the longest of all the things I'm going to show you today, and I am so pleased with the way this turned out.
Aww.
That mattress stitch. This was from a kit.
Mattress stitch or mattress finish?
Well, mattress finish, but the stitch on the side of it, but it is a mattress finish, they
call
it.
What's the stitch? Is it a specialty stitch?
No, it's just all back stitch over
two.
Oh,
okay.
And then joined together. But what that means then is because I didn't use a ribbon or some other kind of fabric on the sides or the bottom, everything was joined with a seam. And they were 70 and 71 and 73 stitches long. But after I pieced it together this way in my mind that I wanted to do it this way, then I started thinking, wait a minute, that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 rows of this I get to do. And it took a little time, but I just, and I did seam the corners as well. So that's not just one wrapped around, which would have saved me the corners, but I like it. I really like the way it came out.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So,
where's your wooden piece?
Behind
me. Oh, okay.
So, I'm going to affix that to the top of my little prim box, and that'll be fun. It is just the slightest bit larger than the actual recessed area of my box, so I'm going to just put it on the top, and I'm going to do it with thread so I can leave it or not leave it.
Yeah, awesome.
But I really...
And what did you put in here? Did
that
you say...
That is finished with pages of batting.
Okay.
I think I showed them when I,
I
had them all together.
You did, yep.
So that's what's compressed in here. And And I really, really like that.
Yes.
I like that one. Oh, but I learned something doing this, and I know everybody, there's nothing new under the sun, but it was new for my little brain to think about it this way. When I'm going 71 and 73 on each of these sides, you're sitting there counting and making sure you've got it right, because that's important if you're doing the join. It occurred to me that if I tack a perpendicular tack every 10th stitch going a direction that's going to get pulled into the seam, I can go back and count every 10 stitches, and it's marked on there, and I don't have to recount and recount and recount. So that's actually what I did, and it made this so much more enjoyable not to have to continue counting. So every 10 back stitches, I just put a little perpendicular stitch into a place that was going to be a seam, and then all I had to do is count those groups of 10 stitches. So that was
cute,
fun and easy. And that was 35 counts, so it was pretty dense to work with, which made it just a little more cumbersome.
Oh, that's cute.
This was one of my Shepherd's Bush, Shepherd's Fold kit from Shepherd's Bush. And I finished that little ruler. It has a front and a back.
Very cool.
And the side is done with a three-sided nun stitch that runs all the way around the long piece of fabric. And then it's folded. And then the way she finished it was a suggested just a running stitch back through those holes on both sides. And so that's what I did. And it came out really cute.
Oh, yeah. It's adorable.
Little, hold your little ruler.
And does she give you the ruler?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The ruler comes with it.
Okay, cool.
Everything in this, everything but the stabilizer came in the kit. I just had to pull some stabilizer out of my stitching stuff.
Cute.
And then I'm sorry to bring the party to a halt, but this will be the last one for today. And this goes back to our little blackbird stockings.
Cute. Oh, look how pretty.
And that's
that turned out so cute.
Thank you. And I said to Deb, I said, beads are stitch. And she goes, light blue beads for the raindrops.
How pretty.
So we did the light blue. And then I just used some e-beads.
Yeah.
And did a little strap to match. Yeah. They had some different colored ones on there.
Oh, isn't that they gorgeous? Did theirs. That is so pretty. I love
these
colors.
So I'll be anxious to do the sweet pea, and I'll have a pair.
I'm glad you did the beads. It's beautiful.
Thank you. It's a little time consuming. I use invisible thread when I bead, and that makes it a little quicker because you don't worry too much about what you're leaving behind.
Wow.
And the way they did this was stabilizer inside to match the template, iron it on, and then you just finger press all the way around the stabilizer, and then whip stitch up the sides. I did like a little blind stitch and tacked it every...
Oh, you closed it up top. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because there's nothing but the stabilizer inside.
Okay. Very, very cool.
I thought it might keep it from fraying if I did it that way.
Yeah.
I didn't... I thought about lining it, but I thought, no, for the purposes of decoration like this, I wasn't going to line it.
So, yeah.
There it is.
Yay!
So.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So cute.
The first piece... First one out of that set.
Very cool. Nice.
So we might get a look at some market stuff in the future. That'd be fun.
Yes.
You're going to be in Las Vegas next week.
Yes.
Fun.
Yes.
It'll be warm.
Good.
Although we're at spring here.
Yeah, it's yeah.
I told Rick, I think we're going to get away with no winter.
I do too. Yeah.
I saw two fawns. Itty bitty.
Did you?
Last night, Ivan spotted them out the back and had a long chat with them. But I saw their feet on the walk that we took, and their little hooves were no bigger than that.
Oh.
They are just, they must just be,
they
just hatched.
Yeah.
They had to have just hatched.
Yeah.
Well,
all right.
We thank all of those people who are having a nice little trip at Nashville right now, the designers and the retailers and all of our local needlework shops.
Yeah.
Everybody who helps to make our needlecraft that much more enjoyable.
Yeah. Yeah. And thank you to all of you who watch and subscribe and hit the like button. Thank you very much.
Yes. It's LCS at the end of our, instead of your LNS, we all know what that is. Now it's LCS at the end of the video, which is like, comment, and subscribe. And that way you'll be eligible for everything.
All right. Well, we will see you next time. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. Share the joy of needlework.
Oh, bye-bye. I missed it.
Yeah, you did.
Let's do it again.
All right. So, as always,
share the joy of needlework.
Bye-bye.
See ya.